Hello friends, welcome back in a Lapi here. Today's session we are going to see VRM circuit in a desktop practically with the help of motherboard and a multimeter. So let's see.
Here is a multimeter and two probes. One is a red and another is a black. First we have to plug this probe into the multimeter. Black probe should be plugged in a common. Here is a common written here. So we plug the black probe in a common and red probe in a voltage. Here give the symbol that is a voltage. Now this is a multimeter which is off. Now we have to set this multimeter to the buzzer range or buzzer mode. Here is a symbol of like a sound, look like sound. That is a buzzer mode. So let's set it to the buzzer mode. So when we connect this probe each other, the sound will be generated like this. So we have to trace the path of VRM circuit. We only have to hear this sound only. Let's see. Here is a SMPS plug, but I already told you there is another 4-slotted socket for a VRM circuit. This is a 4-slotted socket, and VRM circuit is always situated in near to the CPU socket. This is the CPU socket and this is the whole VRM circuit. Let's see VRM circuit. This slot, 4-slotted, 2 are ground. So we have to find ground and supply with the help of multimeter. When ground match, it will give the buzzer, and when supply match, then it will give buzzer. But it will not give buzzer when ground and supply match. So let's see. This all component are grounded. So when we touch this component and this plug, when ground are match, then it will be buzzer. Let's see. This is ground. It gives a buzzer. Another slot is, this is also a ground. Let's see. It is not giving buzzer, so it is a supply, because it here is a supply and here is a ground, so it does not give a buzzer. Here also another slot which is supply, it is also does not give a buzzer. So you understand how to find the ground. Now let's see. We have seen supply goes from this 12 volt socket to the input capacitor. Here is a input capacitor. This is the input capacitor. This is one also input capacitor, and this is also input capacitor. So let's see the supply can be reached to the capacitor. From the back side we have to test. Here is a, this is a capacitor leg. Here is another capacitor leg, and this is a also capacitor leg. So let's see. This does not give buzzer. This give a buzzer or continuity. Because it does not give buzzer because one leg of capacitor is always grounded and another leg is a supply. So when we plug, we put the probe in a supply slot, and when supply match, it will give the buzzer. Another input capacitor, here is a leg of the capacitor. This is does not give the continuity because this is a ground and here is a supply. When supply match, it gives continuity. Here is another capacitor. This leg is grounded and this is a supply leg. Let's see. This is I put this probe in a supply slot, so it gives the buzzer. These three are input capacitor. Let's see input coil. Put this probe into the supply section, supply slot, and this is the input coil. And the leg of this coil is back of the board. So this is the leg of coil. Let's see, this is the input coil or output coil. This is the output coil. It does not give any continuity. Here is no coil in a input. Sometimes they give the coil or sometimes doesn't. This is the output coil and output capacitor. This is the output capacitor and output coil. Here is only input capacitor, but there is no input coil. Now move toward the MOSFET. Here is a three-leg MOSFET. As you see, this is a three-leg MOSFET, three-leg MOSFET. This is also three-leg, and this also three-leg MOSFET. Can you see? This is three-leg MOSFET. This is three-leg. This is a three-leg MOSFET. This is three-leg. Also here is one three-leg MOSFET also. And this is also three-leg MOSFET. So let's find which MOSFET is TG and which is a BG. Put this probe in a supply slot. And supply comes on a drain of TG as we seen in a theory lecture. Let's see, this is a drain. Left side leg is always gate and right side always gate. This is a gate, this is the source, sorry, this is the source, this is a gate, and this is a drain. So right side always gate, left side always, sorry, right side always source, left side always gate, and upper side always drain. So this is a drain of, it gives a continuity, means it is a TG MOSFET. Let's see, this it is a TG or BG. It does not give any continuity, so it is a BG MOSFET. This is a BG MOSFET and this is a TG MOSFET. Let's see this MOSFET. This is also TG MOSFET. Let's see, this is a BG MOSFET because it does not give continuity with the supply. So these two are TG and these two are BG. Here also a VRM circuit. Let's see which one is a TG and which one is BG. This MOSFET gives continuity, means this is a TG MOSFET, but it does not give continuity, so it is a BG MOSFET. Now move toward the BG MOSFET. Suppose now we have seen this is a TG MOSFET. The source of TG MOSFET is connected to the drain of BG MOSFET as you seen in a theory lecture. Let's it is a connected or not. Put this probe on the source and this probe on a drain of TG MOSFET. This such a way we can get a connectivity or buzzer, that is this is a TG, so it is a BG and it is TG. And let's see this one also. This is the source and this is a drain of BG MOSFET. Here is also one TG source and one BG, which is a drain. Okay. The drain of TG are interconnected. This is also TG, it is also connected. This is also TG. They are internally interconnected to the each other. And the BG are, drain of BG are internally connected. These two MOSFET are BG. This is a BG MOSFET. So it gives a connectivity. Now source of the we have seen source of the TG MOSFET is connected to the drain of BG MOSFET. Now let's see source of BG MOSFET. We have seen in a theory lecture source of BG MOSFET is connected to the ground. This is a ground. So let's see, does it give connectivity with the ground or it is grounded? Yes, let me. This is a source of the BG. This is a BG MOSFET, which is a source. It is also ground. This is a BG MOSFET. The source is a ground. Now, gate. The gate of TG MOSFET and BG MOSFET are connected to the VRM IC as we saw seen in a theory lecture. This is a VRM IC. This is a very small chip called a VRM IC. Now let's see connect. Does we get a connectivity of gate to the VRM IC? This is a gate of the TG MOSFET. And suppose if we doesn't give, this gives the connectivity with the IC. This is a gate of the TG MOSFET which connected to the IC. Now BG MOSFET, let's see this TG MOSFET. This is a gate of TG MOSFET which is should be also connected to the VRM IC. This is also give a continuity or buzzer with the VRM IC. That means it is they are both are connected internally. Let's see this TG MOSFET. This is a TG. This gives the connectivity with. Okay. Now let's move toward the BG. This is the gate of BG MOSFET. That is the connectivity to the gate of BG MOSFET to the VRM IC. Now this is a gate of this BG MOSFET. This also connected to the this leg of IC to the VRM IC. Let's see, this is a BG MOSFET, this is a source and this one is a gate. I put this probe here. And this is a give connectivity with the gate of BG MOSFET. Now we have to see output. The output of the core voltage is from the source of TG MOSFET. This is a TG MOSFET and this is a source which is give output to the core voltage. So let's put the probe on the source leg and find the connectivity with a coil and capacitor, that is called input capacitor and output capacitor. These two are input capacitor, these two are output capacitor, and these two are output capacitor. These are output coil. Let's see, find the connectivity with the capacitor. This is a capacitor and this one is also capacitor. This is a coil, this is coil, this is a capacitor, this is a capacitor, and this is a coil. These are output capacitor and output coil. Let's see connectivity from the back side of board. I put the probe on a source of TG MOSFET here. And from the back side, this is the output coil. Coil give the connectivity with the source of TG MOSFET. Now capacitor. This is the output capacitor. It gives a connectivity, sorry. This is also, I think. This is a coil. These are a output capacitor. Here we also get the supply. We give the supply to the CPU section. That is, we should also get a connectivity with the CPU socket from the source of TG MOSFET. I place a one probe on a source of TG MOSFET and get a checking the connectivity with the CPU. This here is I get connectivity with the CPU. That is, supply goes to the CPU. And that is a VRM circuit, all about VRM circuit. So thank you. Hope you guys, you understand the VRM circuit practically and try on your board at home. So you practice daily so you can get easily. So you are able to trace a path of VRM circuit. Thank you.
That's all for today's session. I hope you guys, you are clearly understand VRM circuit in a desktop. If you like the video, give thumbs up. Also subscribe my channel. If you have any problem, leave in a comment box. Also give a comment for a feedback. Thank you. In the next session, we are going to see RAM circuit. So stay connected.